हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल स्टडी अ वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ मेजरमेंट, दैट इज ब्रिज मेजरमेंट। हेयर वी विल स्टडी डीसी एंड एसी ब्रिजेस। दीज ब्रिजेस आर वेरी वाइडली यूज्ड फॉर द मेजरमेंट पर्पस। दे कैन मेजर रजिस्टर्स, इंडक्टर्स एंड कैपेसिटर वैल्यूज, एंड दे आर वेरी पॉपुलर बिकॉज they have high accuracy, they have high sensitivity, and they can measure wide range of quantities. So let's start our topic. Hello everyone, welcome to PRV Solution. Today we will study bridge measurement. Bridges are widely used in the measurement of components such as resistors, capacitors and inductors. They are designed to have four arms with a very sensitive galvanometer connected between two points and the supply at the other two points. So in bridge circuits we have four arms. At two arm we will connect our galvanometer, and at the another two points we will connect our supply. Third is bridges owe their popularity due to high accuracy, high sensitivity and the ability to measure a wide range of quantities. They have high accuracy, high sensitivity, so they are very popular for measurement, and they can also measure wide range of quantities. And the last point, bridges may be DC and AC depending on the component that make up the bridge arms and the kind of current used to energize them. So we have to study two types of bridge here, DC and AC. In case of DC bridges we will apply DC source, and in case of AC bridges we will apply AC source. And DC bridges are used to measure only resistance, while AC bridges can measure resistance, inductance as well as the capacitance. In the case of a DC source, the bridges can be used in the measurement of resistance. I already explained it. In the case of AC source, it could be used in the measurement of both resistance and reactance. Reactance may have inductive reactance or capacitive reactance due to capacitors or inductors connected in any of the arms of the bridge. Typical example of DC bridge is the Wheatstone bridge, while example of AC bridges are the Maxwell bridge, Owens bridge, Wiens bridge, DeSorty bridge, Hayes bridge and Skring bridges. So this is the circuit diagram for the bridge. Here a circuit consists of network of four arms, resistance arms, forming a closed circuit with a DC source of current applied at two opposite junction. So here we will apply DC source at this B and D terminals, and a current detector, it may be galvanometer, connected to the other two junction. This so bridge instruments are classified as DC bridges and AC bridges. DC bridges are resistance used for resistance measurement, where examples of DC bridges are Wheatstone bridge, Kelvin bridge and Mega Ohm bridge, while AC bridges can be used for measurement of capacitance as well as inductive reactance. So for capacitance measurement we will use capacitance comparison bridge, Skring bridge and Wien bridge, while for calculation of inductive reactance we can use inductance comparison bridge, Maxwell bridge, Hay bridge and Owens bridge. So first type of bridge is DC bridge, and DC bridge are used for measurement of resistance. So we will use here three types of DC bridge. First is Wheatstone bridge. This is our Wheatstone bridge. Here we can see that at A and C DC voltage source is applied or connected, एंड एट डी एंड बी अ करंट डिटेक्टर सर्किट इज कनेक्टेड. केल्विन ब्रिज इज शोन इन सेकेंड फिगर एंड मेगा ओम ब्रिज इज ऑल्सो शोन हेयर. सो वी हैव टू मेजर रेजिस्टेंस बाई यूजिंग दीज थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ ब्रिज सर्किट्स. दीज आर ओनली डी सी ब्रिजेस. व्हीट स्टोन ब्रिज. अ व्हीट स्टोन ब्रिज इज एन इलेक्ट्रिकल सर्किट यूज टू मेजर एन अनोन इलेक्ट्रिकल रेजिस्टेंस बाई बैलेंसिंग टू लेग्स ऑफ अ ब्रिज सर्किट. वन लेग ऑफ विच इंक्लूड्स द अनोन कंपोनेंट्स. सो इन दिस केस वी हैव फोर आर्म्स एंड वी हैव टू बैलेंस द ब्रिज फॉर मेजरिंग द कंपोनेंट वैल्यू. इट वॉज इन्वेंटेड बाय सैमुअल हंटर्स क्रिस्टी इन 1833 एंड इम्प्रूव्ड एंड पॉपुलराइज्ड बाय सर चार्ल्स व्हीटस्टोन इन 1843. द व्हीटस्टोन ब्रिज सर्किट इज द मोस्ट एक्यूरेट मेथड ऑफ मेजरिंग रेजिस्टेंस एंड इज यूज वेरी वाइडली वेर एवर एन एक्यूरेट मेजरमेंट इज रिक्वायर्ड. सो ब्रिज डीसी ब्रिज कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू पैरेलल रेजिस्टेंस ब्रांचेस विद ईच ब्रांच कंटेनिंग टू सीरीज रजिस्टर्स. सो हेयर वी हैव दीज टू आर्म्स. आर्म ए सी एट विच आर वन एंड आर थ्री आर इन पैरेलल विद आर टू एंड आर फोर. अ डी सी वोल्टेज सोर्स इज कनेक्टेड अक्रॉस नेटवर्क टू प्रोवाइड ए सोर्स ऑफ करंट थ्रू द रेजिस्टेंस. एंड अ गैल्वेनोमीटर और नर डिटेक्टर सर्किट इज कनेक्टेड बिटवीन पैरेलल ब्रांचेस टू डिटेक्ट ए कंडीशन ऑफ बैलेंस. इट इज सुटेबल फॉर रेजिस्टेंस वैल्यू ऑफ 1 ओम टू 10 मेगा ओम. नाउ वी विल डिराइव इट्स मैथमेटिकल equations. At balance condition no current flows through the galvanometer, therefore I1 R1 is equal to I2 R2. It implies I1 is equal to I3 and I2 is equal to I4. So this value I1 R1 is equal to I2 R2 and this I3 R3 is equal to I4 R4. Because when no current passes through this galvanometer, so what happen? This I1 becomes equal to I3. All current will flow from A to D and D to C, and similarly from A to B and B to C. So I2 becomes equal to I4. That is this condition. So now voltage drop. Voltage drop across R1. Across, we will use here voltage divider circuit. We have to find the voltage across R1, which is equal to V into R1 divided by me R1 plus R3. Similarly, we can find a voltage drop across R2, V into R2 divided by me R2 plus R4. This R1 plus R3. This is the voltage drop condition at balancing. So after some calculation we can get condition for balancing the bridge, which is equal to R1 R4 must be equal to R2 R3. Product of R1 and R4 must be equal to R2 and R3, means opposite arm product must be equal to another opposite arm product of the Wheatstone bridge. Next is sensitivity of a Wheatstone bridge. Sensitivity of when the bridge is in unbalanced condition, current flows through the galvanometer causing the deflection of pointers. Because we are connected here with galvanometer, and when the Wheatstone bridge is unbalanced, then there is some deflection of the pointer. The amount of deflection is a function of sensitivity of the galvanometer. डिफ्लेक्शन डिपेंड्स अपॉन द सेंसिटिविटी ऑफ द कैल्विनोमीटर. सेंसिटिविटी इज डिफ्लेक्शन पर यूनिट करंट. सी दिस इज द डेफिनेशन. वट इज सेंसिटिविटी? सेंसिटिविटी इज डिफ्लेक्शन पर यूनिट करंट एंड इट कैन बी एक्सप्रेस्ड इन लीनियर और एंगुलर यूनिट ऑफ मेजर. सो सेंसिटिविटी इज मिलीमीटर बाय माइक्रो एम्पियर, डिग्री बाय माइक्रो एम्पियर और रेडियंस माइक्रो एम्पियर्स. सो टोटल डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ द पॉइंटर इज गिवन बाय दिस टर्म. डी इज इक्वल टू सेंसिटिविटी ऑफ व्हीटस्टोन ब्रिज मल्टीप्लाइड विद करंट माइक्रो एम्पियर. थेवेनिन्स थ्योरम. थेवेनिन्स थ्योरम फॉर लीनियर इलेक्ट्रिकल नेटवर्क्स स्टेट्स दैट एनी कम्बिनेशन ऑफ वोल्टेज सोर्स, करंट सोर्स एंड रजिस्टर्स विद टू टर्मिनल्स इज इलेक्ट्रिकली इक्विवेलेंट टू ए सिंगल वोल्टेज सोर्स वी थेवेनिन एंड अ सिंगल सीरीज रजिस्टर्स आर थेवेनिन. सो वी विल सी इन नेक्स्ट स्लाइड हाउ वी कैन कैलकुलेट थेवेनिन रेजिस्टेंस एंड थेवेनिन रेजिस्टेंस थेवेनिन वोल्टेज. For a single frequency AC systems, the theorems can also be applied to a general impedance, not just resistors. So, if we have a single frequency AC system, we can apply this theorem to also. But the condition is we must have single frequency AC. The theorem was first discovered by German scientist Hermann von Helmholtz in 1853, but was then rediscovered in 1883 by French telegraph engineer Leon Charles Thevenin 1857 to 1926. So he was the great scientist. You also, I think you also have studied it in your previous semesters. Now unbalanced Wheatstone bridge means air galvanometer is showing some deflection. So we will use Thevenin theorem here to find out the equivalent circuit of this Wheatstone bridge. Thevenin's equivalent voltage. For calculation of Thevenin equivalent voltage, we will open this galvanometer. We will open this galvanometer. We have here two points at A and B. So potential at this point and potential at this point. So we will get AB, which is equal to potential difference at point A and potential difference at point B, that is VAB, which is equal to V Thevenin. It is given by the voltage divider rule. We can get its value E multiplied with R3 divided by R1 plus R3 minus R4 divided by R2 plus R4. So this is the Thevenin equivalent voltage VTH for the given circuit. For calculation of Thevenin's equivalent resistance R Thevenin, we will short this voltage source, means resistance of this voltage source becomes now zero, and we will find the Thevenin equivalent resistance between the terminals A and B. So this is that voltage source which is shorted of resistance 0 ohm, and hence we have R1 and R3 in parallel with R2 and R4. So R Thevenin can be calculated. This combination is in series with this combination, means two parallel combination in series with each other, and so the Thevenin equivalent resistance is this one. If a galvanometer is connected to terminal A and B, the deflection current is the current through the galvanometer. So this C and D we are connecting here galvanometer. So value of this galvanometer current is this V Thevenin divided by R Thevenin plus RG, where RG is the internal resistance of the galvanometer. So in this way we can calculate the value of the galvanometer current by using Thevenin's equivalent circuit for the Wheatstone bridge. So measurement error. So what are different errors that can occur in this Wheatstone bridge? First is the limiting error of the known resistance. You know the limiting error which are specified by the manufacturer for the resistors which have different uncertainty, 10%, 20%, 5%. Then second error is insufficient sensitivity of detector. Detector may be not properly sensitive to the current. Change in resistance of the bridge arms due to the heating effect. Sometimes resistance change when current flows through it due to heating effect, so it will also create errors in the measurement. Thermal EMF or contact potential in the bridge circuit. It will also another source of errors. And the last is error due to the lead connection. Leads also have some resistance, so they will also create errors in the measuring of the resistance in the Wheatstone bridge. Now we will see what happen when there is slightly unbalanced condition present in the Wheatstone bridge. If three of the four resistors in a bridge are equal to R and the fourth differs by 5% or less, we can develop an approximate but accurate expression for Thevenin's equivalent voltage and resistance. So this is the condition. What is the Thevenin value of the voltage source and resistance when we have our bridge is unbalanced or slightly or only slightly unbalanced? So here we Thevenin value will comes out to approximately equal to E cross del R divided by 4R. And how we can calculate this? V Thevenin is equal to VAB. We have to calculate this V Thevenin, which is equal to the by the rule of potential divider. We can get its value E R plus delta R plus R plus delta R minus R divided by me R plus R is equal to E delta R divided by me 4R plus 2 delta R. This 2 delta R can be neglected as its value is very small. So we will get this expression E Thevenin E delta R divided by me 4R. For finding the R Thevenin, we will use following expression. R Thevenin is equal to R cross R divided by R plus R plus R cross R divided by me R plus R. We are not taking here delta R because its value is very small as compared to this R. So we have here R Thevenin value comes out to be R always. So this is the equivalent circuit of the unbalanced bridge which has slightly unbalanced condition, which is an approximate Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Next bridge is Kelvin's bridge. It is also used for measurement purpose of the resistance. This is the modified version of the Wheatstone bridge to eliminate the effect of contact and lead resistance when measuring unknown low resistance. Basically, this bridge is used for measurement of the low resistance that is less than 1 ohm. So this term here RK represent here lead or contact resistance, and this lead and contact resistance have effect for on the measurement of our resistance. So how we can find the accurate value of resistance by using this bridge? Here the condition for balance is this Rx by R2, this one, and R3 by R1 must be equal to Rb by Ra. At point, so this is our lead through which we will balance our bridge. This lead we will slide this lead from M to N points, that is MP and PN points. So how we can calculate the resistance here? So at point N, N is this point, Ry is added to a known resistance Rx. This Rx, we will add this lead resistance to here, Ry, Rx plus Ry here. And if our lead is at point M, then this Ry is added to this R3. So we know that the product of opposite arm of the resistance must be equal to product of other opposite arm of the Wheatstone bridge, that is R2 Rx is equal to R1 R3. But here Rx becomes Rx plus RNP. This is the, if our lead is at this point N, this will becomes Rx plus RNP is equal to R1 into R3 plus RMP if our leads is at point M. Is at point M. So this product R2 into Rx must be equal to this, means R2 Rx must be equal to this R1 into R3, R1 into R3 plus RMP. So after some calculation we will get the values for balance condition is this. This is the final value for balance condition. This R1 by R2 must be equal to RNP by RMP. This one, R1 divided by R2 must be equal to RNP divided by RMP, the lead resistance. Next bridge is mega ohm bridge. As the name suggests, it is used for finding the value of the very high resistances of the order of mega ohm. So high resistance measurements are affected by shunt leakage resistance. So what will be the problem with for measurement of high resistance? In case of high resistance, we must include the effect of insulation of the resistance or insulating material. And whenever current pass through this high ohm resistance, then the current will not only flow through the resistance, but it also flow through the body, which is known as surface leakage current. And due to this surface leakage current, we are not able to find the accurate value of the high resistance. Suppose we want to measure this Rx, which is very high resistance. So here surface current will pass, which is also known as leakage current. So what we will do, we will guard it, that is at this terminal we will guard this leakage current through resistances R2 and R1, so that this leakage current will goes to ground. So this terminal is actually guard terminal is also known as ground terminal. We will minimize this leakage current by connecting this leakage current to guard terminal. The guard terminal is connected to a bridge corner such that the leakage resistance are placed across bridge arm with low resistances. So these are the condition. R1 in parallel with RC approximately becomes RC, R2 in parallel with RG approximately becomes RG, because R1 is very very greater than RC and R2 is very very greater than RG, because these three values are always very high in case of mega ohm bridge, in the order of mega ohms. And the value of the unknown resistance we can calculate RA RC by RB, which is same as Wheatstone bridge, but only here the difference is that we have this extra high resistances, and the use of these resistances are to minimize the leakage current or leakage resistance. So in this way we can calculate high resistance value from the mega ohm bridge.